now invite the Awkulite President, Engr. Ngene, to formally present his welcome address.
Your Excellency, the Nigerian Ambassador to Japan. My Lord, the Honorable Justice Ejioye, Major Generals, Honorable Members of the House of Representatives, Honorable Members of the House of Assembly, Honorable Commissioners, Permanent Secretaries, every other protocol concerned. Awkunanaw. 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 You are in none. Foundation. And the occasion that has brought us here together this afternoon is our annual graduates conference. Our graduates conference of marriage should be coming annually. But as we all know, the beginning of everything is usually not so easy. We started this foundation way back as far as 1995. And that was when we had our inaugural graduates conference. Ever since, we have been faced with some ups and downs and have not been able to organize another graduate conference till date. That is to say, that what we have gathered here together to witness is the second in the series of our annual graduates conference. Foundation, as the name goes, of Awkunanaw origin. When we gather together, we don't have sex discrimination. We have age discrimination. That is to say, that as far as we are graduates, whether polytechnic graduates or university graduates, and age, right, no barrier. The old and the young are free to be members. In the foundation, we have fashioned out a mission that will be our guide towards realizing our goal for the larger Awkunanaw. And our mission is to build bridges between the poor and the wealthy. Above all, the enlightened and unenlightened people of Awkunanaw. That is our mission. In pursuing this mission, we, again, have tried to spell out clear agenda for ourselves in order to realize what we have for ourselves as the mission we are pursuing. So, that agenda we have fashioned out for ourselves, I will take a brief moment to let you know what it is all about. Because that is a clear direction we have chosen to make sure our fathers have labored for by making us go to universities, go to polytechnics, and we have graduated, that we have to pay back by making sure that we leave Awkunanaw a better place. Those objectives we have fashioned out ourselves. The first among all of them is education. Education is our cardinal objective. And we have agreed among ourselves that the best way to promote the community of Awkunanaw is to make sure that, that there is good education, especially for the youths. In doing that, we are aware that some are intelligent, but because of their poor parental background, they are not able to go to school. And that is the more reason why we decided to focus on the indigent ones among us. We are aware that there are students who are quite brainy, have been able to get into the university, but the means of pursuing that their dream to a logical conclusion have been a problem. Is going to be scholarship for the indigent students. And I'm happy to announce to you that today we have 4 students in the university's courtesy of Awkunanaw Enlightenment Foundation and our supporters. When we are talking about sponsorship of indigent students in the universities, we consider what it takes to sponsor them in the university. Because we don't just say we offer you scholarship. We go deep down and see what type of institution is the person. Is it federal university? We calculate the total cost. Or is it state university? For instance, to sponsor somebody in a state university costs us approximately 320,000, approximately. Why in the federal university? They cost about 220,000. Just an approximation. As we get students to sponsor universities, we estimate and make sure that the scholarship enough, that is the benefit of the scholarship is enough to take care of the person. Apart from our scholarship program, we also have bursary program also for the indigenous students. And so far, around this time last year, we were able to offer bursary to 8 indigenous students of Awkunanaw. And by the grace of God, what we write today, we will triple that number in terms of bursary award. Because of the interest our pursuit for education for the youth has generated among the people we have been discussing, we have decided that the best approach to pursue that central goal of education, especially for indigenous students, is to launch an education endowment fund so that we'll be able to pool resources together and from those resources get more and more indigenous students sponsored. So today, we'll be flagging up an education endowment fund to be sure that our scholarship program as well as bursary program will be sustained. Unless we have very conducive environment for learning. But unfortunately, the visit we have made to some primary schools in Awkunanaw leaves a lot to worry about. As you can see, most of those schools we passed through are so dilapidated now that you begin to wonder whether students really still enter those buildings for the purpose of better education. As you can see from the slide, the classroom blocks are quite a nice one. We have a dream for the education of our youth. And we believe that a good environment ensures good education. That is why we have come up with a design of what a good classroom should be like. And that is what we are looking at on this slide. For the larger community of Awkunanaw, we embark on public lectures periodically with Awkunanaw people. And one of such lectures you are going to hear from our one and only ambassador to Japan, Ambassador Gadiago. And by the end of that lecture, we will be sure that Awkunanaw Enlightenment Foundation has some good things to offer for Awkunanaw people. Current development. We know fully well that so many infrastructures are in a terrible state of disrepair where they exist, or in most cases, not existent at all. All right.
This by order of an ambassador, but that's close. Well, that is why we are not. The government cannot be kept away. So, high level, even though that place is a high level, it's as high as every other place. Sorry.
You're welcome, sir. Another club in terms of road construction. Enugu South local government also have been doing marvelously well. But yet there are still some vital roads that have not been touched. And one of such roads is the Awkulite Awkunanaw road. And we believe that with the effort we have put towards ensuring that this road is rehabilitated, and before long, God is giving us to make sure that this road is rehabilitated. We are not overlooking the culture of our people. Awkunanaw has a culture, Awkunanaw has a tradition. But the unfortunate thing is that we have so neglected some of them that some have either gone extinct or in a very sorry state. A typical example of that is our ancestral home. You have Awkunanaw have left it. Sorry, but it looks shameful. Osagwe has produced men of different caliber. Osagwe has produced commissioners, permanent secretaries, successful businessmen, and so on and so forth. With all these people together, our ancestral home should not be left to be so dilapidated as it is. And that being the case, Awkunanaw Enlightenment Foundation also had a dream in that direction. We are thinking that the best thing we can do is to transform our ancestral home into an ultra-modern square, brought up to the standard that is befitting to the people of Awkunanaw. And that is the dream we have. And we believe that with the support of all of you present, support for culture, granted that technology has taken us quite advanced, but then we remember that our people take plane, pay hundreds of thousands of naira, go to Israel, go to Egypt, go to Mecca. What are they going there to do? They're not going to see God. They're only going to see what the old people have done there and what the present generation have left so that people will come and see it. In the same way, Awkunanaw Enlightenment Foundation is thinking that even the way our forefathers lived in the past, that there is a way we can do it today, and it will be a peace for people to come and visit. So in the same way, we are thinking of developing a typical Awkunanaw compound and transform it into a mini museum where all the artifacts used in Awkunanaw or gold will be on display for people to come from even outside the country to see. Our brothers who have challenged for help. And the cry was so touching because they told us that they detest to go to the street and beg. That people that with your support will be able to adequately rehabilitate those brothers or brothers who are physically challenged. But assure ourselves that those dreams are not as if they cannot be realized. Some of our people in Awkunanaw have even started picking those projects one by one. Like I told you, our cardinal objective among all those projects is education for the indigenous students. And that is why I will not conclude this speech without giving special regards and thanks to those who have partnered with Awkunanaw Enlightenment Foundation and invested their resources towards the achievement of some of those goals. And the first among them is Dr. Ngene, who challenged Awkunanaw to show the brilliant indigenous Sachia Koha, who is coming to challenge us to show him a brilliant indigenous student that he will make sure that he invests his strength until he becomes an accountant and even up to his professional qualification. We have done that with the students and students today. Who went ahead and identified a brilliant indigenous pharmaceutical student and the law student? And the two students are today in the university, courtesy of Awkunanaw and Enlightenment Foundation, and the two faculty. The fourth, I think the story about how much he has supported Awkunanaw and Enlightenment Foundation will be better told at the end of this gathering, of what Ambassador Godiabo means to Awkunanaw and Enlightenment Foundation, means to Awkunanaw people, and if it means to Nigeria. Let's leave that story to the end of this ceremony, and you'll be able to have a feeling for yourself that Ambassador Godiabo is a son. What happened in Awkunanaw?
Minding the setbacks, but minding the past programs that always accompany the end of year, especially when it is approaching Christmas, that a good number of you have decided to honor our invitation. I'm quite grateful for that. And to all of you and our members who decided to obey our plea that they should come in time, I welcome all of you to the 2020.